Check. We're both firefighters on our football team still play against one another. I'd also like to take this time to thank and recognize the honorable colleague who passed away last summer. I met Michael in 1980, like all Hudson County people, as soon as we opened our mouths, the story started flowing. Michael was a great person, friend, coach, and husband. If I had to listen to his accomplishments, I'd be here to love him. Michael, rest in peace, will be sorely missed. I hope everyone feels my excitement and enthusiasm here tonight. I've always loved being alive. It's been a part of my life as long as I can remember, from the late 1960s, with the clan of all states till today, still playing the men's teams and all the tournaments. I am now my soccer referee, NCAA, I hope, and USA official. Through hockey, I mean much more than I've ever been back to the game of hockey. My teammates, other competitors have become my very close friends. I have traveled and seen places that I would never see otherwise. Hockey has given me camaraderie, travel, excitement, and an absorbing interest. To put it bluntly, if I had to do it again, I'd do it the same way, it won't be harder. My only regret is that I didn't start playing hockey as a young boy. I started on the ice as a freshman in St. Joe's, West New York. The program only lasted a year, just my luck. But I found other avenues to play, some leagues, house teams, and travel teams. By the time I reached Ramapo, I had a 6'4" frame with just 175 pounds to work with. You should be mad. Put that in. I'd like to thank Coach Archer and Darren Mays. Something in me at the time that he used. I kind of hold him responsible for my whole college career, because I don't think I would stay in school if I couldn't play out. That's what happens when you take something that serious. To me, hockey was as natural to me. They didn't have much to work with, so they showed me how to use my body, which I kind of liked after a while, and to put some weight on the field that I needed. Let's face it, when we first started playing on the third line, we rarely touched the puck. Our job was to keep the puck in the offensive zone by any means possible. If I wanted to play, I had to skate and hit. And hit I did. I tried to knock you to the fifth row if I could. As my roommate and lineman, Fred Cardell, so graciously put it, we were like three bulls in a pen, waiting for the door to swing open. Fred, thanks for getting into that list. I want to also thank Tim Spencer, best trainer I ever could ever ask for. Timmy and I first met the following day after I made the team. He took one look at me and he says, "We're going to have to fatten you up." I would say, "God, you're going to take me." And he was right. Most of my injuries came freshman year. Timmy helped me on so many occasions during my time around him. I'm going to have this way to come home walking to my home and ensure that I recover properly. After I left Ramapo, I kept in touch with him, as he lost my back and lost my knee. I'll always be grateful to him. Coach Fitzgerald, I have to thank you for being a great friend, kind of showing me the ropes before I got too far out of hand. You know what I'm talking about, right? Thank you to John Durden, who ran the interviews and was kind enough to let me work as an official, so I would make some money and stop up there. To my mother and father, who passed in 2001 and 2003, thanks so much for being in that event. My mother was always the voice of reason that always convinced my father to give me money to play in all those leagues. She could always come to me when I got hurt, while my father was screaming at me to hit her, saying I probably deserved it. My mother came to a few games the first year until the upset game, when I got hit in a hockey stick, and I think I swallowed two and spit one at that's deep. Not a hockey player. So she never came after that. But she always would ask how we did when I pulled her up. Thanks to my father, who provided all the lies and practices, the definitely couldn't understand the physical part of the game. He would always ask me after games, you hit those sticks coming across the middle, you're gonna kill one. And as soon as you hit this to him, he saw me get out of my ass a few times. He would always stand by the glass and point, because he said it was too cold for him. You get too excited to sit down. He got a hand in the end of the first season. My father would have gotten a kick out of this tonight. If my father told me anything, he told me to keep my back shut and play the game. But as we all know, that didn't work out too much. He tried to teach me to be humble in whatever I do in life. And if I'm really good at something, to be humble and never rub it in anyone's face. There's always someone bigger than you or better than you that'll humble you real quick. This is not the truth. My brother Joseph, this is my chair, my name is Terry. Thank you for sharing this great night. I love you guys. There are a few years between me and my brother. I don't even know if you can anymore, my name. Have you gone? Since then, too busy being a fireman, but that's why. Thank you, my brother Joseph, who has been my friend since grade school. Now just try to get two friends as possible to do. What great stories to tell our grandchildren. I don't know if I ever told you how excited I was when I had any coming around. Then when we were going to be roommates, I knew the thought was just going to continue, and I gave my father told me I don't think you should go there. I knew the thought was going to continue, like Steve Martin says, we might do heaven. That's how it is, I'm going to be dead forever. I couldn't ask for a better friend, John. Ambitions are not realized, of course, without a lot of hard work. You have to set goals for yourself, you have to train, you have to be single-minded about what you want to do in life. More than that, you have the support and encouragement of your family and friends. To my brothers Veronica and Jamie, I love so much. You two are so mature and wise in your younger years. I know you plan to your height, but someday you're going to thank me for it. Always remember to play hard. Be humble in sports and in life, and make sure you have some fun along the way. To my wife, Joanne, who has stood with me for 29 years in hockey, softball, firefighting, the hockey tournaments, Canada, Las Vegas, and on and on. I always said to people, when you line up to be your genius, and I said, Joanne, I don't think the words I love you ever enough. Thank you, sweetheart. So I've been chosen and inducted into the Ramapo College Hall of Fame as a former ice hockey player is a privilege and an honor for me. But I am deeply humbled by the hockey inductees before me. Father Chip, Harry Mays, Tom O'Reilly, Dennis O'Keefe, Bob Hogan, Rush Cicoli, Edward Chapman, my roommate and good friend Ken Madden, and now Jim Barrow and myself. Finally, remember that nothing in life is worth a damn without family and friends. I cherish all of you that came here tonight and the ones that couldn't make it, so you'll understand what I say. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.